Siobhan here with the Fighting News, and I'm with the legend himself, Professor Royce Gracie. Professor, thank you so much for being with us tonight. It's great to be with you.
My pleasure.
Awesome, awesome. So I have to say that when I was first presented with the opportunity to meet you, I was just like, wow, I get to meet the pioneer of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
As long as you don't choke me, we're good.
And I have to say, it amazes me what you and your family have created throughout the years. And the first thing that comes to mind is, what was it like for you and your family being the first ever to lay the foundation of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu here in America? What were those first days like?
People know us for the fighting, but my father didn't teach us how to fight. He taught us how to teach, how to defend ourselves. So first days coming to America, we were surprised that people didn't know who Hélio Gracie was. So it's in Brazil, everybody knew my family, the name, my father, my uncles. We came to America, it's like, nobody knew. We're like, wow, it's an open market.
An open market, it absolutely is correct. So what were some challenges that you faced, like plowing through that and introducing, you know, grappling to the world? Because that just wasn't around. People were not doing it.
In the beginning, we used to teach back in the garage days, private classes every half an hour. There was a new student teaching private class. We were teaching privates. But then my brother Horton says, okay, for us to reach the world, the mass, we have to put on TV. So that's when he created the first UFC. But there was he created to, in a concept that we brought from Brazil, like to find out which style of martial art is the best.
And what did you find? What was your conclusion?
First UFC was an 8-man tournament. So no time limit, no weight division, no gloves, no rules, just no eye gouging, no biting.
Yeah.
So it was 8-man tournaments, 3 fights in one night. So they got the best champions of their different styles, a boxing champion, a wrestling, a kickboxer, a judo guy, different styles, and everybody representing their styles.
Yes.
And I won the first UFC, 3 fights in one night.
You rocked it.
being the smallest opponent, and I didn't beat anybody up. I just applied submissions. It was like, people are like, wow, what did he do? He didn't even hurt the guys. It was not a bloodbath, nothing.
It was amazing. It was amazing.
Mr. Gracie, it's a pleasure to be here interviewing you. I remember the first UFC, except I didn't see it on pay-per-view. I had to rent it afterwards on VHS. But I was training with a man named Ray Longo at the time, uh-huh. who's up in Long Island, and he's now trains UFC fighters. And he saw the fight. And we came in the gym the next day, and he said, did you see that guy, what he was doing? You know, he'd wait for his opportunity, get right on top, mounted position or whatever, and as soon as your opponent stuck a limb out, it was over. You know, arm lock, choke, you know, whatever, done.
That was the game plan. That's why my father put me. He could have put other cousins or brothers that had more experience on fighting, but they would probably beat up the opponent. He knew I wasn't going to beat them up. I was just going to nice subdue the opponent.
Exactly.
Show the technique of Gracie Jiu-Jitsu.
Did you have any doubts going into that first UFC? Did you ever say to yourself once, why don't they put Hickson or Horian in there? Or did you have
Not
any
at all,
doubts?
Because I want my chance.
Right. What was it like to look at the whole landscape of martial arts in the United States of America back in those days, in the early 90s, and see, like, you know, here's a Taekwondo school, or here's a, you know, here's a boxer. And then, you know, they had no idea how they were going to, you know, what they were up against, you know.
Today, there's wrestlers and judo guys that come to me and tell me, thank you, because go back before the UFC, before the first one, it was 93. Before that, you open up a Black Belt magazine or Inside Karate, Inside Kung Fu, all the martial arts magazine, they only talk about the stand-up arts.
Exactly.
They never mention wrestling, judo, or the Gracie Jiu-Jitsu. But once the UFC came along, that's when we put grapplers, let's say grapplers in general, on the map. So they become, they got exposure.
Exactly. And did you ever have any idea, or was it ever your family's intention to, you know, to create just a fantastic amount of new schools and competitions? And I mean, there's thousands, hundreds, probably hundreds of thousands of people that make a living off of mixed martial arts
now. So it was our plan, you know, to conquer the world? Yes, it was.
You had that, yeah. Said, okay, you said you were down in Brazil and you just looked up at North America.
My brother pretty much came to America and it's like, wait a minute. How come people in the world don't know?
Exactly.
Let's spread out.
So what's it like if you ever walk into one of the larger gyms like American Top Team in Coconut Creek or whatever, and you say all of these people are really here because of your accomplishments?
They're here because of what my father and my uncle Carlos
did. And your family.
I'm just a vehicle to show their technique.
Of course. Do you think someone else would have done it if you didn't? One of your brothers or?
Yep.
Okay.
Just happened to be me.
It just happened to be you. Well, those were great times and those were great fights, and you shocked everyone.
Thank you.
All right. You know, you had a bunch of people that were studying martial arts for years and just scratching their heads and what's this black belt going to do for me now? But, you know, knowing there's guys like you out there.
But everyone had that doubt. Mm-hmm. Like, what if we take all the rules off and have a fight?
Exactly.
You see, so we opened that door for people to find out.
Exactly. Great time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So the finale, me and you, here at Harmony Martial Arts. We're not going to fight.
Oh.
We're not going to fight.
You and me are like, all right.
If you choke him out, that'll probably get us a lot more YouTube views.
He thought I was here before to choke him out, but I told him Gerardo was here to choke him out. So, you know, I'm looking here at Harmony Martial Arts. I'm looking at these pictures of you 30 years ago, like, and it's amazing to me, maybe 25 years ago, it's amazing to me that, you know, you are the face of UFC, the godfather of UFC, and
Bellator.
And Bellator. And
I'm with Bellator now. UFC is always going to be my house.
Yes, yes.
I just built a new one at Bellator.
So what do you think about the new sports coming out of mixed martial arts like bareknuckle fighting?
Bareknuckle fighting, man, I think that's stupidity.
Yeah.
Sorry, man. The two guys stand there and beat each other up to see who can take more punishment. The winner gets out beat up bad.
Yeah.
I don't know if I agree with that. That we create mixed martial art to find out which style is the best, which one is the more efficient. How can a smaller person defend himself against somebody bigger in a street fight where there's no time limit, no weight division? It was a curiosity. The bare knuckle fighting, man, I don't know, man.
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to make it? I don't know if it's going to make it or not, but I'm not interested on it.
Yeah, and
the winners get out pretty bad beat up because they're boxers. So they just stand there and exchange punch to the head.
Yeah. What'd you think of the last weekend? They had the UFC fight, and then they had a pay-per-view boxing fight with
Canelo,
and UFC was on, and they took a back seat to the UFC. The boxing took a back seat to UFC. They waited till the main event was over. They had Canelo lying down on the couch waiting. They actually had to stop. Danzin stopped. What do you think of that? Taking a back seat to UFC.
People more interest on mixed martial art.
Yeah.
So nothing wrong with boxing. I trained boxing. My sons trained boxing. But you see, I think mixed martial arts is more exciting. People think it's more exciting.
Well, again, we're here, everyone. We have 100 students here waiting to get your tutelage, so we're going to let you go. We appreciate you
Thank
taking
you.
The time with us. And, Us.
I appreciate it.
Thank you so much.